Hi, I'm going to show you today how we can make a stamp, something like this or similar. And afterwards, I'm also going to show you how you can simulate in order for this stamp to look like it actually was stamped. So let's get on to it. Let's open a new document. We'll call it stamp. For default purposes, I will use the web and I will accept everything as it appears. So first step, we're going to use the ellipse tool to build up some circular shapes. I'm going to duplicate this shape. If you press Alt and using the selection tool, you can duplicate whatever objects you want. And after the first duplication, if you just press Ctrl D, you will repeat the same operation several times. This will allow you to build up a series of circular shapes, all with different sizes. This will become useful for our tutorial needs. Do remind that everything that you are building here can afterwards be aligned. You just have to select everything, and you see here on top these icons here in the control panel, and we are going to press the horizontal align and afterwards the vertical align center. So everything fits it. We are also going to remove the fill here. We only have to press this button. And now I'm going to change color of these two circles, because this will be the two circles that we are going to use to write down the text we need here inside. We will need the inner circle and the outer circle as the external dimensions of our text. Going to resize this a bit more. Keep in mind that if you do this resize while pressing Alt key, the resize will be concentrating towards the center of the object. At the text tool, you will select the type on a path tool. And first we are going to select this inner object, and we are going to write the sentence that we need. Quality control. Let me resize this. I'm going to enlarge it until it reaches the outer red line that we draw, so 69 points. After that, I will choose the other, because I want the other text to be written from here to there. And I'm going to click to use also the type on a path tool, and I'm going to click it up, and I'm going to write 100% approved. These lines that you see here, this one marks the final part, and this one in the middle allows us to indicate if you want the text to come inside or outside our path. First, I'm going to put it here. Afterwards, I'm going to drag this and specify I want it towards here. I'm going now to draw some lines to serve as a reference point. Obviously, you can also do this with guidelines if you do prefer. I didn't notice that the text was selected, and that was the reason why it changed the outline. We'll fix it afterwards. We're just going to use this red line as a reference so that the dimension here is more or less the same. Also this one here, we are going to try to align it. I'm going to use this tool here, which is the eyedropper tool, to make that text same as this one. So, now that this is done, we can just lock it, because for the moment we are not going to use it. And we are going to use these two circles, the inner one and the outer one, to build a single shape using the Pathfinder. So, just open the Pathfinder. If you don't find the icon here in the floating panel, just come here at Window and hope the Pathfinder. Or else just press Shift-Control-F9 or Shift-Command-F9 if you're using a Mac, as I am. And after both of them are selected, just press the second one. You have to make sure that the bigger circle is behind the other one. So arrange, send to back. And now this one and this one should have no trouble being intersected. I'm going to send this back, and I'm going to make everything visible. Object unlock all. I'm going to select this one, and I'm going to ask it to become white for us to see. White. And we can already see something. I'm going to make this thicker. I think this looks out fine. And I'm going to draw some shapes, for example, some stars. I'm going to click it and do a 7-point star, for example. I'm going to change also this and put it on white. And I'm going to select that tool and resize the shape down. This will sign the difference between the quality control text and the 100% approval text. So to duplicate this, I just select it and press the Alt key and move it across the artboard so it reaches the other part. I'm going to delete these two red lines because I don't need them anymore. And I'm going just to draw some shape there inside that I feel comfortable. Just going to use the pen tool to draw something here. If you pay attention to this icon here, drawing modes, you can switch from new objects being built above the other ones. For example, I draw a new rectangle and it will appear on top of every other object that was already on the artboard. Or instead, if I want to, instead of drawing normal, draw behind, means that every object that I'm going to draw now will appear underneath all others. So this might be useful, for example, if you want to simulate the application of this stamp on top of a color paper, for example. And from here we can see that the whites in the text are appearing not as empty spaces in the stamp, but instead as white spaces. So we have to fix this. And the way that we can use to fix this is to transform the text in outlines first, all of it, and using all these objects that we have here, also this other star, and selecting this outer shape, we can use the shape modes. This means that the shapes that we are building now are actually holes in the middle of this. So after all this is done, we are going to group it. For us to simulate what you see here, this sort of paper texture, we are going to use a file, which is a texture file. I have one right here, for example. This is it's a white JPEG with a lot of black dots. And we are going to use this to build up a mask. We are going to the transparency panel, which is here, and we are going to make a mask. And this mask, we are going to select it. By default, this was selected. We need to press here for this to be selected. We are going to do File, Place, and we are going to find out our texture document, and we are going to place it. And notice that when I move this object, what is going to happen is that whenever I have a white space, it will become a transparency. This done, once again, we can test it by putting something underneath and you'll see that the transparency is working. I can now put this stamp on top of whatever artwork that I'm doing, and no matter what background I have, being a picture, a photograph, it will always work out fine.